judgeship for YFM, but I just have to say that I'm really filled with so much joy right now. And the reason why I say joy and not happiness is because happiness is so circumstantial, whereas joy is definitely like a base feeling that goes beyond circumstance, beyond the fact that it's 4:15 in the morning right now and it's freezing cold outside and I'm trying to last off this Red Bull I drank 2 hours ago, etc., etc. I'm so incredibly blessed to be able to do what I love. Now, that's not something that most people get to do, right? It's such a privilege to be able to sit in a studio, play music that I love, guys. Come on, Janae Aiko is playing right now. Have Jay Huss on the way. Davido also played in the mix. Also had... okay, just give me 1 second. I have to see to my work first. Okay, everything's sorted. Basically, I just want to say that I'm filled with so much gratitude that I get to be here. I moved from Western Cape to Gauteng, completely different provinces and definitely a completely different reach when it comes to radio. And it's just been such a good but challenging time. 2017 has definitely been a trying year for the human race. And I believe that when it comes to trying times, it only definitely pressurizes us, pushes us, grows us to be prepared for the next level, right? There are levels to this game and we only want to climb higher and higher. So 2018 is literally just a couple days from now. And it's kind of cheesy to be like, 2018, new year, new me, new goals, new aspirations. But one thing I can say is that 2018 holds so many treasures, holds so many new gifts, holds so many new opportunities, holds so many unexpected, beautiful surprises, holds so many lessons that all I need to do is be open for and not see them as moments of self-pity, although it's okay to be in your feels, but definitely kind of recognize it as, okay, God, what are you trying to teach me right now? Which has kind of been my approach going month after month in this year where I thought I wouldn't make it through, but here I am, still standing, technically sitting, but you know what I mean. Standing on the inside. Hey guys, what's up? Okay, so I am particularly excited today. Today is my last show on the playground. I've been doing it once a month for the past couple of months, and it's been such a learning experience. It's been such a humbling experience. And honestly, I've realized that every single day, there's nothing else that I can feel, or nothing else that I want to allow myself to feel in terms of the space I'm in right now, except for gratitude. And of course, I let all sorts of thoughts come through, all sorts of emotions come through. I don't deny or block any of that. But the one that I'm letting grow, the one that I'm strengthening within myself is gratitude, because this opportunity, I mean, coming to a new city, not knowing anything, not knowing anyone, has been a huge test of faith in my life. It's been a huge test of my character. It's been a huge test of how badly I want this, how badly I want my desires, my dreams, my passions to manifest in my life. I want to get to certain levels in my life, and I knew that the only way to get there was to put in the work. And that work included moving cities, shaking up my life, and entering into a space that scared me. Like, my fear crippled me for months, months and months and months. Not only my fear, my self-doubt, which I guess kind of works hand in hand, and also just my anxiety was flaring. It's been the most I've had to deal with in the past couple of months, but I wouldn't have had it any other way. I think that in my life in particular, I really can't talk for anyone else's life, and also I can't speak to anyone else's belief system, but in my life and my truth basically is that everything that I've been through has happened for a reason. The really, really crappy stuff, the really incredible things have all kind of culminated to get me to this point where I'm like, I like the woman I am, actually. Today is my final show on this time. It is currently 4:20 in the morning, but we're good, we're surviving, not even surviving, we're thriving, we're slaying, we're doing all those good things, and I'm really excited for
for the next part, for the next chapter.
I am out an hour and a half out of Joburg at Bosberaad, which is basically an annual gathering for all the YFMers. Me, of course, being one of the newer members of the on-air team. Very exciting. It's a time filled with conferences, time filled with meetings, talks, direction, and getting to know one another really well. Maybe over a glass of wine or five? I don't know. I guess we'll see how the night unfolds. But I'm very excited to just, you know, be hotel living for a little bit before the madness of being on air starts. And it's gonna be a little crazy. I'm anticipating a lot of excitement. I'm anticipating a lot of anxiety, but obviously channeled into nothing but good energy. And I don't know, I'm just in a really, really good space right now. So I'm trying to soak it all in. As she stands there, singing one morning. Ooh, ooh,
ooh. Oh God, it's Major League. I wake up every morning singing for money. For money. I'm singing. Okay, now go buzz on the back. Hey, I get come on your swag and jenga. I get come on your shine, go my jenga.
So this is my official 30-minute marker until my first show, well, first official show in YFM from 7 till 10 weekdays, and I'm not alone. They told me that I couldn't be. Apparently, I'm not good enough. I only filled the glass up to about 3/4. We needed that little bit. That little bit more.
I'm here too.
In the form of Sibu Mpanza.
I'm here too. This is going to be amazing. 7 till 10, 99.2. Oh my goodness. I'm so excited.
What's your excited, Don?
Because it's Carissa's first show.
Hashtag
runs down. It's going to be the best show in the freaking world. I thought I'd give her some flowers. So you spoke about flowers and how we both have new places and we need some color. And this specific flower, it's called the chrysanthemum, right? Chrysanthemum. Apparently, it symbolizes loyalty, right? So I'm like, I got you. So this is for you.
Oh, Steve, thanks. And the card?
And the card, Joyce. You want to see the card? Okay. Also, I got her a card. Even though my handwriting is horrendous.
I'm a very emotional person.
Oh, you're a very emotional person.
I am.
It says I owe you big time.
Oh.
Because when she got the gig, she was like, I know exactly who I want to work with. Gave me a call. I was like, I'm
You owe me nothing, though. Except for good content
exactly.
And amazing co-hosting.
And loyalty.
And loyalty. Please. Do you have any advice for a newbie?
Just take it easy. Why do I look like I got makeup?
You're looking good.
Thank you. No, literally, just take it easy, have fun, relax. Don't overthink it.
Mm-hmm.
It's gonna be fucking amazing.
Oh.
You didn't get here because but it's because we
if
are
you
shisa.
Have nothing to say, just play music. That is always. And if it goes quiet, fire!
I mean, you cannot go wrong with starting off the show with some of this. Absolutely love this track and love the combination. Nikki doing a thing with ASAP Ferg. It's called Plain Jane. We are anything but on the show today. I am anything but, might I add, as well, right? My name's Carissa Cupido. Welcome to the show. I'm not going to take you alone, though, for the next couple of hours. It's going to be a bit of a menage a trois. You, me, and somebody else in studio on Run This Town, the first official Run This Town of 2018, and the first one on YFM as
woo,
well.
Woo, woo! It's Sibu Mpanza here to join you.
It is Sibu Mpanza, indeed.
I'm so excited!
I can tell, Steve, you're dancing in studio. You've been jamming to all the music so far as well. And I don't know if you're looking forward to the next 3 hours, but I, without a doubt, am seething at the mouth.
It's going to be hot. It's going to be absolutely hot. We've got the best music in South Africa.
Come on now.
Tell the people why we run this town.
Exactly. Indeed. Listen, for the next 3 hours, you can expect some goodness. I don't know if you were listening a couple of minutes ago. I spoke to DJ Sappy as well as Tippy. Shout out to them for taking you for 4 hours on the absolute best drive. We're going to talk a little bit about Nomza Mombata and how gorgeous she looked at her graduation, and also to all the other grads out there securing those degrees, let us know head over to the Twitter sphere. You know where to find us at YFM. Also send through those voice notes. Let us know if you have bagged a degree this year. What was it? How many years did it take you to get there? Because for some of us, it takes a little bit longer. We take the detour.
Ooh, sis, or it just doesn't happen at all.
Or it just doesn't happen at all. Listen, it's either the scenic route not happening or just like me. I did it in 3 years, 4 years.
Yes!
I mean,
we're not ready.
We're going to talk about that in a little bit, so don't go anywhere. This is Run This Town.
Run This Town with Carissa.
Weeknights from 7 p.m. to 10 p.m.